Hey guys, welcome back to our video of creative process. Today we'll be creating an isometric cone using Illustrator and Photoshop. The design consists of cone with a concrete texture applied over the surface. So we'll create the cone in Illustrator and use Photoshop to design the whole composition. So let's start out with the rectangle tool. Left click your mouse button and the rectangle panel will open. On the rectangle panel, put the width value 200 points and the height 70 points. Give it a stroke color and remove the fill color. Change the stroke thickness to 0.25. And after this, we'll add 7x20 division to the rectangle. To do that, go to Object, Path, Split to Grid. In this panel, put the value of 7 rows and 20 columns, then click OK. We got a grid. Now select all and group it up. Now we'll bring a concrete texture, scale it down and adjust the size according to the rectangular grid. Make sure the edges are a little extended, then we'll create one more rectangle on the top, adjust the size according to the outer edge of the grid. Now selecting the rectangle and the texture image, make clipping mask. Make sure the images are embedded. Next, arrange the texture layer to the back and group the design. Now we'll convert this into symbol. So open the symbol panel, drag and drop this design, give it a name and click OK. This will create a symbol which can be applied to any design. Now let's create out our cone. So to create that, we'll use the rectangle tool and draw a square of 1 point stroke thickness. Use the scissor tool to cut the square diagonally and then delete the top half. Now using the die selection tool, set the top anchor points toward left and push it upward. We'll give a stroke thickness of 0.25 and use the shape to create out the cone. So go to Effect 3D Revolve and the 3D Revolve panel will open. First we'll change the color of the cone to green. Then again, open the Revolve panel under Appearance, take the Preview option to see the changes and we'll give X axis 35 degree, Y axis 0 and Z axis 0. Then click OK. Let's do little adjustment with the anchor points to increase the height of the cone. Now we'll add a texture. So open the map art. Here on the top surface, put the texture symbol. Adjust the size and place it properly, leaving some area on the top. Then click OK. We'll duplicate this and change the rotation value minus 35 degree. This will create a cone of different perspective view. Now expand both the cone and ungroup it twice. Move the top layer aside and delete the rest of the pieces. In the same way, delete the background shape of the other cone. Now select the texture area and release clipping mask, then ungroup it. Do the same for the other design. Then select the top shape for both the cones and make it a flat surface using the unite option from the pathfinder. Change the color to light green and group it up individually. Now open a new Photoshop document, drag and drop both the cones and scale it down. Now using the single column marker tool, draw out a vertical line, create one more duplicate. Next, select the cone and give it minus 120 angle rotation. Rotate the line with the same angle, place it properly, duplicate it a few more and set it up for the alignment of the cones. Next, we'll duplicate the front faced cone and arrange the layer to back. Place it properly. Arrange it according to the front cone. Next, we'll rotate the other cone to 180 degree angle and place it around here. Duplicate one more front face cone and push it down aligned to the lines. Lastly, we'll duplicate our final cone and arrange it to back. Rotate the cone and place it beside the top face cone. Here we can see the cone is missing some details in the texture, so we'll do the adjustments. So double click on the smart object of the cone and it will open in Illustrator. Here we'll do the corrections. We'll select the texture and release clipping mask. Then again select and release clipping mask and finally save the files. Changes will be automatically updated in our main design. We'll do the correction for the other cone. So open the AI file by double clicking the smart object. Here ungroup the cone and by selecting the texture, release clipping mask, then save the file. And you can see we got a nice detail in the texture of each cone. Let's reduce the opacity of the line to 27% and lock it. Now let's give some depth to the design. We'll add shadows to each cone. Select the cone and create duplicate. Change the color mode to multiply and adjust the opacity. Add a layer mask to this layer. Now using the soft brush tool, you can hide out the area where you want to give highlights and erase the tool to add shadows. Play around with the opacity and the size of the brush. Give a nice fade between the highlights and the shadows. To remove the effect from the green surface, select the area using the matching wang tool and apply black color to hide. In the same way, we'll add shadows to all the cones. Use the eraser tool with larger opacity to add dark shadows between the corners. This will give a realistic feel to the design. The dark shadows added between the top and the bottom cone adds up the depth. Remove the shadow between the remaining tip of the cones. Add a shadow between the two surfaces to show division. Finally, adjust the opacity for each mask layer. Finally, add a text, set it according to perspective. Add adjustment layer to do some color corrections. Under the curve adjustment layer, set the red curve little up, green curve and the blue curve. Increase the contrast value and reduce darkness. And lastly, add up the text with the proper font. Finally, our isometric cone design is ready. The cone is totally customizable. During the project, we have understood the use of the revolve option, how to create texture symbol, and the mask option to add depths. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.